class 5 animals everywhere. This is lesson number 2. Okay children, so we have completed the till the migration, we have completed, right? Okay, animals everywhere, lesson number 2. Let's start. Okay, gave one word answers. First one, the breathing organ of fish is known as what? Gills. You have to write here children, what? Gills. Okay, the breathing organ of frog on land is called as, or is known as, lungs. Okay, the breathing organ of frog on land is known as lungs. It is known. Okay, so the fish is in the water that have what? Gills. But the frog on the land, it is an amphibian, so it has lungs. Clear children? Next, cows, goats and deer are known as herbivores. What they are known as? Herbivores. We have seen in the feeding habits of animals, right? In that, herbivores. What is the spelling? Just see and write children. Okay. Next, ants, cockroaches and butterflies are known as what? Insects. Okay, please write children. Yes, now we are going to go for the textual reading. Okay, the children who has not written all these, please stop the video and pause the video, you can write. Okay children, next, let us see all the explanation part or textual reading of this lesson. Okay, let us start. Look carefully at the pictures of the animals below. Can you guess why they are grouped in 4 separate columns? You have carefully we look this picture children. This picture is camel, cockroach and on land. Okay, next one is on trees. Monkey, woodpecker, squirrel. Next one is in water. Fish, frog, crocodile. In air, eagle, butterfly, bat. What you are able to conclude all by seeing these pictures children? Yes, these are different animals living in different environment. Okay, so they are asking na, can you guess why they are grouped in 4 separate columns? Yes, obviously, because animals are on the land and few animals on the trees, like birds, like woodpecker, squirrel, trees, monkeys, panda, right? And in the water, the animals in the water also, and in the air also, right? So they are separated because of their habitat, that we are going to learn, right? We see animals on land, on trees, in water and in air. Yes, so what are the things we have seen? On land, on trees, in water, in air. The natural home or surroundings of an animal where it lives, eats, grows and has babies is called its habitat. Let us learn this children. Okay, the natural home or surroundings of an animal where it lives, eats, grows and has babies is called its habitat. What is the habitat children for the animal? Where the surroundings of an animal where it lives, eats, grows and has babies, means reproduction, okay, is called as habitat. Please underline children this habitat. And please learn the spelling also, H-A-B-I-T-A-T, H-A-B-I-T-A-T, habitat. Again we are saying the what is habitat, the natural home or surroundings of an animal which it lives, eats, grows and babies is called as habitat. The large animal kingdom consists of different types of animals, okay. So, the large animal kingdom, see, the animal kingdom consists of so many types of animals, children. So, Oh, they are, and they are different types of animals. Their organs of breathing, feeding, and movement are suited to their habitats. Okay, their organs of breathing, because all they don't have same breathing organs, right? And they are not eating only one thing, right? Carnivores are eat only flesh of other animals. They can't eat grass, right? Movement. See, if you see all the animals, their movement is different from each other. Yes, if you see the insects, if you see the animals, if you see the birds, their movement is different from each other. Okay, children. Now let us see. First one is breathing in animals. How the breathing mechanisms of animals is there, okay, is present in the different types of animals, that we have to see. Okay, animals need to breathe to get oxygen. Why animals breathe? Animals breathe to get oxygen. Yes, because animals need oxygen only, and where it comes from? It comes from plants. Oxygen burns the food within their bodies and releases energy for various activity. So when the oxygen enters into our body, what it does? It burns the food. How it burns the food? Through the process of metabolism. That we will be learning in the higher classes. Okay. So it burns the food within their bodies and releases energy for various activity. Suppose you have eaten a healthy food, okay, and it will gives you a energy, and you can do the work. So those work is called as various activities. For that you need to have what? You need to have energy, right? Turn to the next page, children. Yes, animals get their supply of oxygen from their surroundings. So where they will get this their supply of oxygen? From their surroundings. In the surroundings, if lot of plants are present, they gives us oxygen, right? Land animals breathe in oxygen from the air, while the fish and other aquatic animals take oxygen from water. So land animals, we know the land animals, they are taking the oxygen from the surroundings. In the surroundings, so many plants are present, trees are present, they are continuously exchanging of gases. There is a exchange of gases, okay, and carbon dioxide is released by the plants, and oxygen is carbon dioxide is released by the animals, and oxygen is released by the plants, in which the plants use the carbon dioxide for their preparation. And animals get oxygen from the plants to burn the food, and they get energy, right, children? Yes. But what about the aquatic animals? Aquatic animals take oxygen from the water. So most of the animals are taking the oxygen from the water itself. Suppose in the water, water plants are present, like aquatic plants are present, they gives rise to oxygen. And if the plants are also not there in the water, then oxygen is already dissolved in the water, okay, and they get oxygen from the water itself, okay. And which breathing organs are present in the different animals, we will see in this next paragraph, that we will see in tomorrow, okay. So if you have learned today what is habitat, okay, we have learned about you have written about all the points in this, different animals, different types of animals found in the different environment, and what are the breathing in animals. Okay, children? Yes. So I want you to learn about all these things, okay, at least learn the what is the definition for habitat. Okay children, take care, bye bye, and tomorrow we will do this one, okay. I want you to read the lesson and try to and just try to how to read the lesson and just post me in the group whether how you are reading. Okay, children. Thank you, children. Bye.